But your feelings about the character of Superman being added to the show, even on this whatever level it is,
right.
And Tyler being cast.
I have been saying this. Last season, whenever Kara interacted with Clark through instant messaging and however she texted him, I never felt like it was real. There was always something missing, and I always wanted them to interact. And they care so much for each other. She has things she doesn't have, he has things she doesn't have, but they can learn from each other. So I think it's perfect. And I'm so excited that Tyler is perfect for the job.
So with the cliffhanger from last season, you can pick whatever job you want at Catco. What job did you want after you read the script?
Isn't that crazy, that working girl moment? I had ideas, and I'm actually really happy with the way they've written it, and because the career she chooses is one that she is not prepared for. And she chooses the one career that she's like, I know I'm not going to be good at this. So there's so much room to grow. And it's like, she's the bravest character I've ever played. And I can't wait to get into it.
I'm excited to see it. How about the DC crossover? Are you excited for that?
Oh my gosh, it's like every I think that we'd be stupid not to do it. I mean, always say that for everybody. It's so fun to see those characters interact. Like, what will Arrow and Supergirl be? How will that look like? You know, he's so much darker and rougher than she is. But there's so much room to explore. So I
mean, last year when we sat down at one point by accident, about the hope that Supergirl represents. I mean, I feel the show has more hope than Batman vs. Superman or Man of Steel together, frankly.
Yeah.
What's your feeling about that now, having played it for a year, even that's a year? Does it capture that sense of hope that you were hoping for?
Yes. Yeah, it does. One of the things that I admired most about Kara is her huge will. And the fact that she was never, ever given it. And I really think that she doesn't lose any of that fight. One of my favorite monologues that I got to do was when she was speaking to Kat Grant about how everyone in the city is a natural city of life, and she feels like a good bit of everyone inside of herself, that she wants to protect them. And that's what she's been trying to do. And I think now, especially in today's climate, it is essential. And we want to hope, we want to escape and feel like that there is good in the world. So I do feel like we achieved that. I wouldn't want to make that out there. It's so important for my
cosmos. So the money's going much further, so that now the show is about to get larger. Have you sense of that in the scripts? Have you sense of that in the story?
I have sensed just overall in general, and I didn't think it was possible, but even just a grander scale of epicness. A lot of characters, a lot of action. And everything that we loved doing last season is there in the three scripts.
Can I?
Go for it.
They're very nice to me. Taking the writers out of the equation, where would you ultimately like to see? What role would you like to see?
I just prefer, there's no one specific thing, but what I want the most to see this is to keep exploring that maturation of her, really find her owning her womanhood, who she is, growing up, you know, a lost little lamb at some point last season, but then this crash course of finding out who she was, her being a superhero. And I want to, this season, I would hope that she finds solid ground.
Thank you.
Thank you.